With a franchise that's so big on death scenes, it's pretty easy sometimes to see some death scenes as being a little out of touch with reality. And with the Scream franchise leaning very much into that slasher genre, there's always going to be one or two scenes where people will genuinely think that has gone too far in terms of reality or being real. But one of the death scenes that people keep asking me to talk about is Phil Stevens in Scream 2, to explain exactly what exactly went down with that death scene and answer that big question of, what was the actual plan with that death scene? Well, luckily I've decided to piece together all what we know about the characters and the killers as well from Scream 2. And in this video, I want to break down and tell you exactly what I think was the plan that was going to happen in Scream 2 in that movie theater.
Like scary movies.
Hello everyone and welcome to Beyond the Mask, where we talk about all things Scream and Halloween. If you're interested in Scream and Halloween content, or you just like Ghostface and Michael Myers in general, don't forget to hit the subscribe button and make sure you hit the bell icon to stay notified for future content. Just a notice that by hitting subscribe today, you're becoming part of the Scream and Halloween community that I'm building up, and by hitting subscribe you can take part in polls and discussions that I'm posting every single day. So this actual topic of Phil Stevens has been something that's been asked quite a lot. You know, a lot of people have been saying to me, can you please explain how this death worked, or you know, what was going on in the scenes and so on. So what I want to do is I want to cover the actual death scene itself and tell you exactly why this does actually make sense and what I believe Mickey's actual plan was with this death scene. So getting straight into the scenes itself, as you take notice, Phil Stevens does actually go into the men's bathroom, in which he then sees two people dressed as Ghostface. He then decides to go and use the cubicles, as the two Ghostface are pretty much hogging them urinals. So he decides to go into the stall, and when he gets to the stall, one of the doors is shut, and then he says sorry. Now, people sometimes say that this was sort of over the top, and why was Ghostface in there waiting for him to show up? Well, in my opinion, and this is where I'm going to put my own spin on this now, I don't think that anyone was waiting for Phil Stevens to show up in that stall. I believe what was happening was, I think that Mickey had actually gone into the men's toilets, and I think he was changing into his Ghostface outfit. And I think the actual plan was for him to go out into the theatre, and I think the plan was to kill Phil Stevens and Maureen in the screen in itself. And that's something that people sometimes overlook. I don't think that for one moment that Mickey himself intended on killing him in that stall. I think it was just potluck that Mickey was getting changed in that stall. And then the moment that he heard Phil Stevens' voice saying sorry, I believe that that was the moment he realised who it was. So that's when Mickey changed his plans, which is one of the reasons why I think he was such a clever ghost face, because he was able to think on his feet very quick, and it's quite obvious with that if you watch some of the actual kills in Scream 2. Mickey was very good at killing, but also very good at thinking very quick on his feet if something didn't go to plan. And he managed to dispatch Phil Stevens in that way. I don't think it was a badly written death or a death that was too far-fetched. I just think it was mere coincidence that Phil happened to go to the bathroom at the time when Mickey was in that stall getting changed. But the initial plan was for him to go outside to start killing Maureen and Phil Stevens in the commotion. Now, for all we know, there could have been a Mrs. Loomis in that theatre as well. We just don't know. I'd like to think that that was probably the case, to sort of maybe lend a hand in the stabbing. But then again, it's unsure, because it was definitely Mickey who killed both of those characters. And I know that the Scream Wikipedia lists that Mrs. Loomis killed Phil Stevens, but I just don't believe that at all. I think that it was Mickey who did it, and he was getting changed in that stall, and the whole death scene was just mere luck on Mickey's part, that he was getting changed and Phil Stevens went to use the bathroom. And I believe that the actual plan was to kill both of them in the middle of that commotion during the stab showing. What do you guys think was meant to go down in the screening? So if Phil Stevens didn't go into the bathroom and Mickey didn't find him there, what do you think was the plan in the actual theatre screening itself? Had Phil Stevens stayed there with Maureen? Comment down below and let me know what you think. I'm fascinated to hear what you guys have to say about that. So thank you very much for watching the video, guys. Don't forget to like this video, because that lets me know that you're enjoying this content. And be sure to check out my channel right now to see other videos on Scream and one on Halloween at the moment. And without further ado, I'm going to leave this on a Maureen Evans / Phil Stevens scene from Scream 2.
Bitch, hang the phone up and start 69 his ass. Damn.
Like scary movies.